हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। वी वर डूइंग बेकिंग सोडा एंड आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू दैट व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर बेकिंग सोडा, दैट इज सोडियम हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट। ओके, एंड व्हाट इज द नेम गिवन टू इट? सोडियम हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट कैन बी कॉल्ड एज सोडियम बाइकार्बोनेट। ओके, एंड आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू हाउ यू कैन प्रिपेयर सोडियम हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट। इफ आई टेक एनी ब्राइन सोल्यूशन अलॉन्ग विथ सीओ टू एंड अमोनिया, देन आई एम गोइंग टू गेट अमोनियम क्लोराइड अलॉन्ग विद सोडियम हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट। एंड आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू दैट वट आर द यूजेस ऑफ सोडियम हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट। द फर्स्ट यूज विच वी कैन से इट इज एक्ट एज अ एंट एसिड। ओके, एंट एसिड्स आर द सब्सटेंस विच आर acting opposite to acids. Okay, whenever we are suffering from acidity, we are providing base to us. How? By we can take a pinch of baking soda and a lot of water, number one. Number two, we can take ENO also, which contain MgOH2. What is this? This is magnesium hydro oxide. Okay, it is also a mild base which is used for eating purpose, isn't it? Then next, in soda acid fire extinguishers we are using baking soda. Then next, we can use them for cooking purpose. I have explained you by these equations that what will happen when the baking soda is heated up. It will give NaHCO3, will give sodium carbonate along with water and CO2. What will be the role of CO2? CO2 will make the things soft and fluffy. Okay, and I have explained you that baking powder is the solution of baking soda plus tartaric acid. So up to now we have completed baking soda. In this video we are going to read washing soda. Okay, washing soda, as the name indicate, can you tell what will be the uses of washing soda? Yes, washing soda is used for washing purpose, isn't it? So washing soda is the substance. With the name also we can say washing soda is the substance which is used for making the soap and detergent, isn't it? So whenever, what is the formula for washing soda? If I take Na2CO3 along with 10H2, what is this 10H2? This 10H2O is called water of crystallization. Okay, and this water of crystallization is responsible for the colors of any substance that we are going to discuss in our next video. Now you have to learn that what is the formula: sodium carbonate plus or dot 10H2O. What I will call Na2CO3 dot 10H2O is called washing soda. And how it is prepared? I have explained you that whenever we will take NaCl, okay, NaCl along with water, along with CO2 and ammonia. You remember this equation? This equation we have used for the preparation of baking soda. So then what product we are going to get? NH4Cl along with NaHCO3. This is baking soda. And when we heat this baking soda, what I will get when I heat it? Do you remember? I will get here Na2CO3. along with H2O. Isn't it? This is the same Na2CO3 which we have used here. When we add 10 water molecule to it, then it will become washing soda. How I can add? If I take Na2CO3 sodium carbonate plus 10 molecule of water, then it will give Na2CO3.10H2O. I think this is clear to you. And what it is called? It is called washing soda. Okay, the whole process I have explained you again, that how washing soda is prepared from baking soda and how baking soda is prepared from, yes, then we can prepare it with the help of NaCl. You can see here, NaCl was taken as a raw material. When we add water to it, then I am going to get the product, isn't it? So now let us do some uses of baking soda. What will be the use of baking soda? First, I have told you that use of baking soda are, they are used in making glass, soap and in paper industries. For making soap, detergent, we are using washing soda, isn't it? Then it is used for making another sodium compounds. Another sodium compounds like borax. Borax is a compound which is made by adding washing soda. Okay. Then it is used as a cleansing agent. Yes. For cleaning purpose, I have explained you that in domestic, at our home, we are using it for cleansing action. And very important use is, it is used for removing permanent hardness of water. Very good concept it is. What is hardness? You must have heard about two types of water. One is soft water, which is not hard in nature, which did not contain salt mix in it. Okay. And another one is hard water, which contain the carbonate and bicarbonate of calcium and sodium. Okay. So they all are called hard water. Soft water is used for drinking purpose. Okay. Whenever if we apply soap in hard water, we are not going to get any foam. F-O-A-M. Foam means, in Hindi we can say jhag. Okay. So hard water did not give foam with soap, whereas soft water always forms foam with soap, soft water. Okay. So to remove the hardness of water, we are using washing soda. Now I was talking about this water of crystallization. What do you mean by water of crystallization? The water molecules, we can say that fixed number of water molecule present in one formula unit of any salt. If you see, Na2CO3 is a salt. It contains some fixed amount of water molecules. So these water molecules are called water of crystallization. I can take many other examples also. For example, you must have heard about copper sulfate. Remember, copper sulfate. What was the formula? CuSO4. Okay. You are always using copper sulfate, but the actual formula of copper sulfate is, it will have 5 H2O molecules also. What are these 5 H2O molecules? The 5 H2O molecules are water of crystallization. And you know that it have blue color, isn't it? The blue color is due to the this presence of this water of crystallization. When I heat it, what will happen? If I heat it, then CuSO4 will get separate, okay, and 5 H2O molecule will get separate. and the blue color of this copper sulfate will disappear. Okay, I think you must have remembered that in chapter 1 we have done displacement reaction, and I have taken a test tube. In that test tube we have taken solution of copper sulfate, isn't it, in aqueous form, and then I have added iron nail to it. Then what was happening in that, the when they react with each other, then the solution color changes, isn't it? The blue color has changed to green. Do you remember it? Why this green color occurred? That is, it loses the 5 water molecule from it. That's why it's changed the color. So whatever crystals having color, that crystals color are due to presence of water of crystallization. And once again I will explain what is water of crystallization means. The fixed number of water molecule present in one formula unit of a salt is called water of crystallization. First example we have taken of washing soda. Second example I can take of copper sulfate. And third example I can take of FeSO4. This FeSO4 is having 7 H2O also water molecules. Okay, this is the third example. And fourth example also I can write CaSO4.2H2O. It is called gypsum, which we are going to read in our next video, isn't it? Calcium sulfate dot 2H2O. This is called gypsum. Then fifth example also I can tell, that is CaSO4 dot half H2O. This is called plaster of Paris, POP also, and I can say plaster of Paris also. So in this video we have done washing soda, how washing soda is prepared and what are the uses of washing soda, and what is water of crystallization. And I have given you answer of a question, that are the crystal of salt are really dry? No, the crystal of salt are not really dry. They have, what they have? They have water of crystallization in it. We have done first example sodium carbonate dot 10H2O washing soda. Then CuSO4 dot 5H2O. What is it? Copper sulfate. Then FeSO4 dot 7H2O iron sulfate. Then CaSO4 dot 2H2O, which is called gypsum. And the last one which you have done, CaSO4 dot half H2O, which is called POP. So I think all these things are clear to you. Now you can easily tell that the crystals of salt which we have, they are not actually dry. You must have seen also, whenever your mother keep the sodium chloride out, the common salt out, she used to pour this common salt in glass bottles, isn't it? The bottles which are made up of glass, and she always keep it airtight. What will happen when they are kept in open? When they are kept in open, then you will see that they will absorb water molecule from the atmosphere and become dry, and that are not fit for use also. Okay, so I have explained you the water of crystallization, and whenever any crystal is having color, that is due to presence of water of crystallization. Okay, and we can call this copper sulfate also hydrated copper sulfate. Why this hydrated word is used here? Hydrated means, since they contain water molecules, therefore in mix they can be called copper, hydrated copper sulfate. So I think all this process is clear to you, and we will do POP, plaster of Paris, in our next video. Thank you and have a nice day.